Hey everybody. Today we're going to take a look at antiX. antiX23. antiX is a Debian based Linux system that uses the IceWM desktop or window manager. It's not a desktop manager, it's a window manager. So here we are on the installer screen. So we're going to go ahead and double click on the installer and get it started. This is a custom installer here, so it's not a Ubiquiti or Columnaries, it's something all on its own. So let's see what it says here. You got a terms of use. Okay. Then we have regular install using the entire disk. Yes. Okay, the format, yes. Installation in progress. Computer network names. Not sure what that is. Let's see. America, English, time zone, US. It's not Eastern. It's Pacific. Default user login password. Put this very secret password in. Root account. Root super secret password. I'm gonna set it to auto login just to make things easier on myself. Save live desktop changes. Sure, why not? I think that'll make it so when I log in, it'll automatically go to 1080p and things like that. I'm hoping at least. If not, then we'll figure out what it does when we get there. All right. So while it's actually installing, we're adding all the user info. So it kind of like makes use of your time in a smart way. But now we're just waiting for it to get fully installed. I don't think there's any more info I need to add. So it's just a waiting game now. So if it takes a little while, I'll go ahead and cut it out and while I'm editing the video, just to make things fly. All right, well, that installed in about 2 minutes, it looks like. Automatically reboot the system when the installer is closed. Yep, finish. RDT del Popolo. RDT del Popolo. I'm gonna have to Google that, see what that means. Okay, nope. My screen is still at it's not at 1080p the way it was supposed to be saved, but I think we can fix that right now. Outputs, virtual resolution, 1920 by 1080, and just hit the checkbox. And everything right now is a little screwed up as far as the wallpaper and things like that. So what you do is you go to log out, restart session, and it restarts the whole session. See? And it fixes everything. Puts the conky where it's supposed to be, fixes the wallpaper and everything. So we'll go ahead and close this. Alright, so as stated before, this is the IceWM window manager. It's kind of like open box. There's a lot of keyboard action in this, but as you can see, if you right click anywhere, it'll open up a menu. And it's pretty much the same menu that you'll get down here. So yeah, it's similar to open box. Alright, so let's check it out. There's no welcome screen or anything like that, so it's just straight to the point. So down here on our panel, we have a clock. Opens up the calendar. Then this is our system processes task manager. Pretty useful. Okay. Yeah, because it's a window manager, it opens everything on the top left corner, and then every new window is open, you know, chronologically in a certain order. I don't know if it's set up from top to bottom or top to going right, but on window managers, that's how they open up the windows. Or some windows, at least. Just open up straight up in the middle. And this is a common system tray. Alright. We have a volume rocker. Now, what happened there? I don't know. Somehow I grabbed the that. Don't know how that happened, but hey, let's try this again. Then we have our common system tray again. All right, then we have our workspaces. So second workspace, first workspace. Then pinned to the panel, we have our icon manager. Not sure. Not sure why it was needed, but it's there. Then we have our web browser. Let's see what web browser we're using. Firefox. Alright. And what version of Firefox are we running? 102.14.0 ESR. Oh yeah. I have to remind myself. This is a Debian-based system. So, you know, Debian, they kind of lag behind a bit on their software. For good reason, of course, but there it is, Firefox 102. Let's see if we get some info on antiX. Antix, Linux.com. Okay, Antix is a fast, lightweight, and easy to install systemd free Linux live CD distribution based on Debian stable for Intel AMD 86 compatible systems. Antix offers users the Antix magic in an environment suitable for old and new computers. So don't throw away that old computer yet. You hear that, folks? Don't throw it away yet. All right, that's your web browser. And next to that, we have our file manager. And what file manager is this? Well, let's find out. Okay. Does it not tell you? Let's see. I gotta find the about. Alright, it's not reading about, but there's a freaky ass. How do I see help? Don't need that. ZZZZFM. I guess. ZZZFM. Is that I've never heard of ZZZFM, but that's what it is. The ZZFM user's manual. Should have opened your bar, but if it didn't open. Alright, so I guess it's the ZZZFM one. ZZFM is what we're viewing here. But yeah, it's a window manager. Right click it, it gives you certain options. Alright, let's see what these check marks do. Alright, do they change the layout? Go back. All right, that's your file manager. And next to that, we have unplug removal devices. A removal drive with a mounted partition is found. It is safe to unplug it. Okay. Then we also have a software installer. Is this going to be Synaptic or just a software? Looks like it's going to be Synaptic, being that it's Debian based. Oh, it's not. It's its own installer. Well, let's see what this installer is called. Package installer. Package installer for antiX Linux. All right. You're full of surprises, antiX. But that's good. I wonder if there's any relation to the MX Linux crew. Oh yeah, copyright MX Linux. Says it right here. Alright. So I guess this is broken down into, let's see, popular applications. Now we're downloading the package installer. Don't know what that is, but let's see. Okay, so let's see the audio category. The console, it has a console audio there. So let's install Audacious. What else? Clementine. Let's install Clementine. Browsers. I don't need to install any browser. Children. Nah, I don't need that. Let me close that before we get into another universe. Desktop environments. Don't need to do that. Development. Looks like we already have Genie. I'm guessing that this is already installed because we have the check mark. But just in case it's not, let's do that. Check out Adam. This recovery, docs, nah. Email, nah. File manager, Rockfighter. I guess Rockfighter is ZFM. ZFM. That's crazy. We got Space FM. Let me go ahead and install Nemo just for shits and giggles. Alright, I can skip it out of this. Let's see, where's GIMP? Latest GIMP. Full icons, not worried about that. Media center. Cody, nah. Media converters, nah. Not worried. Here. Non-free. Non-free video codecs. Yeah, something you always want to add. LibreOffice. Office. LibreOffice full. We'll go ahead and install that. Video, we got SM2. SM player is pretty good, so I'll put that one down. Wallpapers, we already have the antiX 21 wallpapers. All right, so let me see. I'm gonna hit install and see what happens. Respond here or just press enter. So I guess it's doing like terminal. There was a problem updating sources and sources. Okay, no problem. The following patches were selected. Click show details for list of changes. Need to get it. Okay, just do your thing. Okay, I guess if it needs my attention to do anything, I would add it right here. So it's kind of like being on a terminal, but instead of just typing it right here on the screen itself, I'll type it right here down here. All right. While that's installing, let's go ahead and move along. Antix Updater. I'm not going to click on that because while I'm installing this, I don't want to activate another installation process. Let's see. Okay. And then right here, Skippy. Okay. What is Skippy? Right, so one way to find out. What just happened here? Alright. Click on Skippy XD and it. What does it do? Does it take like a screenshot or something? Or? I don't know what the hell is that. I don't know if anything installed, but so what's happening right now? Is it still during the installation? What the hell is it doing? All right. While that's going on, let's go ahead and look at the application launcher. We have app select. See what that does. I guess if you're searching for an application, it'll find it here. Okay, I guess GIMP didn't install, so. Is this all your applications? Let me see what's on, what I know is on there. Firefox. All right, so yeah, it just searches your applications and then finds it for you. All right, is there an about for this? There's not, that I don't see at least. All right, back to that. Okay, I did not do that, but. Terminal, we haven't seen a terminal yet. It's using Rocks Terminal. Rocks Term 2.9.5. Alright. So, package installer. So, this is stuck right here. I'm going to go ahead and close this. Let's see if we can. LibreOffice, Clementine. Let's try. Alright, so we're having problems with dependencies, I guess. So, I guess I'll leave that alone. Alright, that was your terminal. We already saw file manager. We already saw the web browser. Let's see what text editor. Genie. Okay, here's a Genie. Fast and lightweight IDE. Suleiman. Alright, Genie 1.38. Alright. Now we have a normal applications menu. Here pretty much shows you everything that's on the system. So you can just imagine going through one by one through all of this. It would be, this video will be a couple hours long. But I'll just show you from the drop down menus what all is on here. I guess Office is already on here. Okay. Well, we'll go back to that. But right now I just want to show you everything that's on here. Applications, personal, recent file list, desktop, other desktops, desktop folder, settings, focus, preference. And then you go over here and it opens up to a bunch bar. Just keeps going. We got themes. So right now we're on, I believe we're on F and FX start. But we'll get back to the themes and we'll take a look at them. What was that? Applications and accessories. What do we have? We have calculator. Leaf pad. That's another text editor. Search monkey. Another search tool. ZFM file search. Every time I say it, it just makes me giggle. ZFM. Calculator. Calculator is what we have here. See, 7, 8, 9. Times 6, 9, 8. It equals that right there. I can confirm it. And on the about, we have calculator 2.1.4. All right. Close that. Applications. Got games here. Boss Box and Jones Graphics. Mirage. I believe Mirage is just a regular image. Yeah, it's just an image viewer. So you had an image, you would navigate to your image location. And then you'll view it here. And let's see, about Mirage 0.11.1. All right, just a simple image viewer. See what else we got here. On the internet, oh, there's quite a few things here on the internet. Firewall settings, email, FTP clients, hex chat, yeah, pretty much everything you need. Now on the multimedia, let's see, what do we have that's familiar here? We have a celluloid. One of my favorite. Simple and to the point. Celluloid 0.20. I think it's up to 26. I don't remember 100%, but I think it is up to 0.26. But that's celluloid. All right, applications, multimedia. For audio, what do we have for audio? These are your system audio setters. But an actual audio, I mean, you could open the audio with celluloid. Poor man's radio player. What's this, like a terminal-based radio player? Huh. Select the category and press enter. So let's try 12. Select the station. Let's just go around.
That's the sound of me prepping dinner with Reynolds Wrap. And the sound of me not doing dishes. And the sound of my family having more
Okay. Wow. Pretty good. I've never actually used this before, but something I'm going to look into. I guess it opens up radio stations. Nice. Never even knew this existed. Hey, for someone who uses Linux a lot and doesn't know something, it's pretty good. All right, then we have preferences. Here is where you have like your display settings, internet settings, mouse configurations, onboard, just like an onboard keyboard, things like that. Oh, there is a synaptic packet manager here, but I'm not gonna mess with that right now. But while I am here, let me see if, look at the wallpapers. Static. Add random wallpaper, select picture. All right. Select a step process, but hey. It does what you want it to do, so it's not bad. Alright, pretty simple and straightforward. So you got your wallpaper manager right here, antiX wallpaper. Let's see if they have a on themes. Pretty sure they do right here. Yeah, themes. So right now we're on F, effects dark. So the themes right here are weird. It like changes everything, but it's all in your menu. So let's say if I want to use the bleed huge, see how everything changes. Settings, themes. Want to go green small. Notice how everything changes. Settings, themes. Let's try C, glass huge. So huge, I guess it makes a big old panel. Let's go to G. Let's go to groove medium. Not bad. I'm just skipping letters here, but you kind of get the point of what I'm doing here. Pretty pink medium. Nah. I actually like this one. Accents are cool and everything. All right, so this is antiX Linux. It's pretty cool. It's not my cup of tea, but it's Linux, so it's pretty cool. If there's something that you like and you want to check out, I'll go ahead and put a download link in the description of the video. Also, a link to the homepage and some info on it, so you can go ahead and check it out for yourself. That's going to cut it for me on this video, so I'm going to go ahead and check out now, and I'll see you guys on the next one. And I'm out.